Okay, with Cloud Compare open, we are going to load a test file. You can go through File here or with this icon. And we'll select the last file with the extension sub here. The last file is a file for airborne LiDAR data. We'll go back to this later. For the moment, you're just going to follow what I'm doing. You, on the first menu, you press Apply, and then you press Yes. The data is currently being loaded. So in Cloud Compare, the main window here is a 3D view in which you'll see your data appearing here. This is your airborne LiDAR data. On the left part of this 3D view, you have the database tree, which shows the available and the loaded point clouds. Here we have one point cloud, it's signaled by this little cloud here. If you click here, you see that this point cloud is selected and it is signaled because you have this yellow rectangular element surrounding the data. If you untick this box, the data will not be visible in your 3D view. Okay. Below this database tree, if you have a point cloud selected, you will see the various properties of this point cloud. We'll describe them in a subsequent video. And you have obviously various menus and icons here around your 3D views. And at the base, you have a console which will display some information depending on the operations you perform. So now we're going to explore how we can manipulate the data in 3D. So if you left-click on your data, you can rotate it around this little yellow sphere, which is your rotation point. If you right-click, you can move it in the various direction like this. And using the scroll button, you can zoom in or zoom out. Okay. We can, for instance, zoom in very close to the data, and you'll see that what we are actually seeing is really point clouds. The data is made of individual points. If your points are too small and you want to increase the size, you can go on the left corner with your mouse and you can increase the size of your point cloud like this. Okay. If you are completely lost in your data at some point and you want to get back to a general view, you select your data and you go on the magnifying glass here on the left, you click and you'll go back to a general overview. You have a set also of predefined views. Here, for instance, this one is quite useful. This is a top view and the data is aligned here, as you can see, along the X and Y direction, okay? You'll note that you have a scale which is here. You note that in Cloud Compare, you don't have any units indicated because by default, Cloud Compare use the units of the data which were encoded in the original file. And typically for airborne LiDAR data, the coordinates are in meter. So here the scale is in meters. If you now want to Okay, I'm now going to show you a few simple operations on point cloud. One of the first things to know with Cloud Compare is that there is no undo button, which means that if you make a mistake, if you delete one point cloud, you're going to lose it definitely. So it's a good thing to, for instance, duplicate your point cloud to test some various calculations on it and leave an original one available. To do that, you select your point cloud and you're going to go in this icon here with the two ships. It's a clone of the selected entities. And here you create a clone version of the point cloud. It's exactly the same. Now suppose that you have a very large point cloud and you'd like to reduce the number of points. The number of points is visible here on the right, 8 million points here.
So you can use the subsample function. There are two ways to subsample. One which is purely random, that is you set the number of points you'd like to remain, let's say 50,000. And Cloud Compare will randomly pick 50,000 points and create a new subsample version of the data. Okay. The second version here is with the space function. Here, you're going to impose a minimum distance between the remaining point after subsampling, for instance, let's say 2 meters. And Cloud Compare will ensure that there is no point closer than 2 meters in the final data set. And this is just removing data. You're not resampling or anything, it's subsampling. It's a bit longer. And when you look at the data, it really looks like the original, but if you zoom in, you can clearly see that the density of points has decreased and it's also much more regular. If I compare with the original version, it's definitely sparser. And if you look at the final number of points, we have less than 1 million points. So a very useful function to quickly reduce the number of points. When you start to have several point clouds, sorry, like this in your database tree, it's interesting to try to start to organize things a bit. So you can, for instance, add an empty group, which is a directory, call it test, and you can move your point cloud in it. You can obviously rename them, spatial subsampling, for instance, etc., etc., so that you can keep track of things. If they are all visible, if you untick on a directory, they all disappear. Okay, so I go back to the original data. A function that is very important that you'll use frequently is the segmentation tool, the manual segmentation tool, which allows you to cut various parts of the data. To use it, you need to think that we are going to cut in 3D, and so you need to choose the orientation that best suits what you need to cut. For instance, if we want to cut, you see these points here, we have a bit of eye noise here. We are going to make sure that they are clearly visible, and we're going to press the sizer button here. You have a new menu opening, and as it says, you can start clicking with the left button and carefully select the point you're interested in. And at the end, to close the loop, you right-click like this. Then after, you can choose to either keep the inside part or the outside part. Here, we are really interested in the outside part, so we click here, and Cloud Compare shows a preview of the resulting data. If you're happy with removing the data definitely, you can press on the bin here, and it will delete the points which are not visible. If you want to cut the data in two, then you use this. Here, we're interested in removing the noise, so we are going to delete it, and there is no new data created. But if we want, for instance, to cut the data in two parts, we can select, for instance, a top view. Then we go back to sizer, and if we want to have a rectangular selection here, we can select it, and we can do something like this, for instance, here. And if we're interested in this part, but we don't want to lose the other one, here we press the green button here. And now two clouds are produced. The previous one has disappeared. You have the segmented one and the remaining one here. So if you have made a mistake you want to undo this operation, you can do it by simply selecting the two clouds. You click on one, and then with control left click, you select the other one. You can see the two yellow boxes here, and there is a merge function here, which will create two clouds, and you can keep track of the original cloud by choosing yes to this question here, and it creates a new point cloud with a scalar field here, which is called the original cloud index here. Finally, when you have many data like this, and if you want to save your work, quit Cloud Compare and be able to reload as you were, you can set everything under a single directory like this, work for instance, and if you press on the floppy disk here, you will save everything in the project in a bin format, which is a format only dedicated to Cloud Compare, but it's a very quick way of saving data and loading data and keeping your work as it were. So somehow, even if you don't have, for instance, the undo button, I suggest that you frequently save your work as a bin file like this. Okay. Obviously, you can select individual point clouds and save them with various file formats like this. You can find the details of this format in the Cloud Compare wiki. Finally, a bit of terminology in Cloud Compare. Point cloud is a set of unorganized points with coordinates in 3D, x, y, z. Okay, and for each point, you can have a scalar field attached, which is a numerical attribute. For instance, backscattered intensity, the flight land number, the slope. You can have any number of scalar field. And operation can be performed on scalar field. It will be shown in a subsequent video. You can also have, and this is specific, a RGB field specific to the color of each point. In RGB, the values are coded from 0 to 2555 on three channels, the red, the green, and blue. You can convert RGB field to scalar field so that you can do operation on it or anything, and vice versa. And you can also create, for instance, if you don't have any color on your point cloud, for instance, if you don't have colorized point cloud such as with terrestrial LiDAR or structure from motion, you can add a uniform color to each cloud, for instance, to simplify the visibility of clouds. And you will see sometimes a name called Oak Tree. The Oak Tree is a subdivision of the 3D space made to accelerate operation on point clouds. You don't generally need to know about the Oak Tree. So to illustrate this terminology, in this dataset, you see on the left, when you select a point cloud, if a RGB field exists, and I created one specifically for this tutorial based on the intensity of the laser, you can select RGB. If you don't display any information attached to the point cloud, what you'll generally see is that is you don't have any texture, so it's very difficult to see the landscape. What you can use is a real-time shading effect, the EDL effect, which is very efficient and shows you the relief. Now you can switch to RGB here. This one exists, but you can also create a new RGB field from colors and, for instance, based on the elevation, like this. This one is a RGB field. It could also be a unique color, for instance, like this. And if you display the scalar field, that is different because you need to go down and you have various scalar field available. We'll describe them later. And you can change and affect the color and the visibility of points, something you can't do with the RGB file. So this is why they are different in Cloud Compare.